Hello everyone, welcome to the lecture on Trigonometric Survey and Location. Introduction for Trigonometric Survey. The Trigonometric Survey is a part of survey in which we have the control over the horizontal as well as the vertical distances. So we can measure the horizontal as well as vertical distance and the elevation of different points through the Trigonometric Survey. The trigonometric survey, the instrument tachometer, it seems it's almost similar to ordinary theory light only. Only the difference that the ordinary theory light, which is fitted with the stereo diaphragm, is known as the trigonometric survey. In generally, other kind of instrument like dummy level or third light, they have through telescope we can see only one crosswire. Actually, if you see this kind of only one crosswire, we can see. Why in case of the tachometer, it has the stereo wire also, that it has two stereo wires, so something like this and this. So in the tachometer survey, if you look from the telescope, you will find two more stereo wires apart than the crosswire. So what is the tachometer? The tachometer, it is the ordinary theory light only, which is provided with a stereo diaphragm. What is the stereo diaphragm? This is the stereo diaphragm. The stereo wires is also provided along with the crosswire, that is what the stereo diaphragm. These are what the stereo diaphragm. The stereo diaphragm varies from instrument to instrument. It is not always that the stereo diaphragm will be like this only. It may vary. It may be of some other kinds also. What are those? This is the crosswires. This is one which you are seeing here. Apart from this, this may look this kind also. The full length. Or double line, double body line at center. This is the crosswire and these two. It may look this kind also. These all are known as the stereo diaphragm. So the tachometer is what? The tachometer, it is the ordinary theory light only, which is fitted with the stereo diaphragm. These are called the stereo diaphragm. What is the primary objective? Why to go for a tachometric survey? The primary objective, what to say, the preliminary objective of tachometric survey is for preparation of contour plans. Suppose if you want to prepare the contour plan for a hillock, for a valley, then what to do? Then we can go for only for tachometric survey. With the help of tachometer only, we can prepare the contour plans for hillock or the valley. Well, if you are going for a block contour plan, we can use the dummy level, but with the help of dummy level, we cannot prepare the contour plan for hillock. So, in that situation, In that situation, we have to prefer the tachometer survey. To prepare the contour plan is a preliminary objective of the tachometer survey. Apart from that, what we can do other than this? It is also suitable for preliminary location survey of what? We can do the preliminary location survey of railway, highways, bridges. That also we bridges as well as for reservoirs, canals. It can also there also for all the preliminary location survey of all these things also the tachometry is preferred. Apart from that, the survey of steep ground also, for that also the tachometry survey is preferred. And the last one is for surveying of water bodies. For that also the tachometry survey is preferred. What are the different systems of tachometer? We have three different systems. The one is, you can see here, the stereo method. In the stereo method, we have two, that is fixed wire method as well as the movable hair method. method and the spatial instrument. Among all, the fixed wire method is the most popular method. So let's start with the first one. Let's understand this. What is fixed wire method? The fixed wire method, with the help of this fixed wire method, we can find out the distance as well as the elevation of different points. That is, we have done the horizontal as well as vertical distance. The vertical distance here is referred to the elevation of the points. So we'll take the example. Suppose this is a fairly level ground. Here we have kept the station. This is the instrument station point. This is the height of instrument. This is a telescope. We are interested to find the distance of this point and distance of this point from the instrument station. What is fixed wire method? In the fixed wire method, with the help of fixed wire method, we can find the horizontal and vertical distance of different points. Here, what we do in fixed wire method, we keep the tachometer fixed at one point. We don't change the position of tachometer, but we keep the staff on different points whose distance need to be determined from the station point. Suppose these are the points whose distance need to be determined from the station point, so we will keep the staff on these points. The other points, we keep the staff from this point, and with the help of flexor is the T1. How to find out this D1, D2, D3, that we will see in upcoming case 1, case 2, and case 3 for different conditions. Let's first understand the principle of this fixed wire method. Let's take a case of fairly firm ground. This is the instrument station point, and this tachometer. This is the telescope. This is the point, first point. This is the second point. And this is the third point. This will be the horizontal plane of calibration. We call this as HPC. This will be top wire reading. This will be bottom wire reading, which will change corresponding to the staff. Let's call this point as a dash. This one B dash. Let's call this point O. This starts O dash. Corresponding to this will be then A double dash. This will be A triple dash. This will be B triple dash. This will be B double dash. This is O double dash. And this will be O triple dash. So, in the triangle, what the principle says that in the triangle, O, A dash and O dash comma from triangle O A double dash O double dash comma from triangle O A triple dash O triple dash. We can write that O dash divided by AB dash equals to this distance divided by this distance. It will be equal to this O double dash divided by this A double dash B double dash. A triple dash divided by B triple dash. This will be equals to half of cot of this angle. Let's call this alpha. So half of cot alpha. Let's say this is equivalent to k. K is here. What is k? K is here. Multiplying constant. Why? The alpha is a parallactic angle. So this is the principle of fixed wire method. Now let's discuss the different cases of this fixed wire method. We have divided this fixed wire method into three cases: case 1, case 2, and case 3. The case 1 is for to find out distance and elevation for horizontal side. So let's discuss the first case, that is case 1, distance and elevation for horizontal side. This top point, this point where I kept my instrument. This is the telescope. This will be the horizontal plane of collimation, as well as this will represent the central hair reading also. This will be top hair reading. This will be bottom hair reading. Let's call this as point A. Let's call this as point B. We are interested to find out the distance from A to B. Let's call this as distance D. The instrument, the height of instrument from the ground station is, let's say this H. Here, as we are saying that this is the central hair reading, this is the point B. So this is representing the vertical height or the distance from the ground, that is B. So we can write that this distance from the point B, this will be CHR. This will be CHR. So we can write we are interested to find the formula D here. The formula for D will be D equals to KS plus C. Here S is nothing but this top intercept, that is this distance. Difference of top hair reading and the bottom hair reading. So the S is difference of THR and VHR. This is what D. Here the K is known as the multiplying constant. Why? The S is sharp intercept and C is additive constant. We know the formula for K and S. The K is nothing but F divided by I. F is the focal length of glass, while I is steady interval, and C is the additive constant. C is nothing but F plus D, where we know that F is the focal length, while D, it is the distance of object class from true near axis. So we can keep this value, we can substitute this value here. So D at the place of K, we can write F by I. S is nothing but distance intercept. At the place of S, we can write the difference of THR and VHR, that is top hair reading and the bottom hair reading. Plus C. C is what? It is the addition of F and D, that is focal length, and D is distance of object class from true near axis. So we can write the F plus D. This is the generalized form for D. The distance of instrument, distance of station B from the instrument station, that is point A. This is the HP, suppose the RL of this point, this instrument distribution is known. The RL of point A is known. And you are interested to find the RL of HPC. So, the RL of HPC will be, we are at this position. The RL of this point is known. We are interested to find the RL of HPC. So, how to reach from this point? We know this. So, RL of IS plus the instrument I, that is H. If we add both, we will reach at this position, that is the SPC. So we can get the RL of SPC equals to RL of instrument station plus instrument height. If suppose we need to find out the RL of B point, we need to find out the RL of B point, then how to reach from, and RL of IS is known, then how to reach? We can start from here, the RL of IS plus the height of instrument, we will reach at this position, means we are at this point, then we need to reach here. What we will do? This point, RL of HPC plus the CHR, means the RL of IS plus H minus CHR minus central air reading, then we will reach at this position. So that will be the RL of B. RL of SPC minus CHR. This will be the RL of B. If it RL of IS is not, we can calculate the RL of SPC, and then by subtracting the value of CHR, we can get the RL of point B. This is the case one, that is distance and elevation for horizontal side. Now let's move to case number 2. The case number 2 is distance and elevation for angle of elevation. This is the instrument station. The staff is kept here. Let's say this is the point B. This is the point A. This is the telescope. So let's say this is the height H. That is the height of instrument from instrument station. This is the HPC. This is the horizontal plane of collimation. This is the THR. This is the center hair reading. This is the bottom hair reading. This is the instrument height. So this is the point B. So this is the CHR, so this distance will be, this vertical height will be CHR. Now, another term we will introduce here, that is the B. This distance from CHR, level of CHR from the HPC. This is called the B. The height of, or the distance of CHR from the horizontal plane of collimation, we are giving a term, we are giving abbreviation to this, that is the V. So this is the V, that is the CHR, this is the HPC, the H is the height of instrument, instrument from the instrument station. And let's say this point O, this as point C. Here in this case, the L equals to OC is equals to KS cos theta plus C. We are interested to find the D. D is the distance of point from instrument station. So D will be, it will be L cos theta. We can see in the triangle O, C, and let's call this point as P. So from the triangle O, P, C, सी इफ द OC इज इक्वल टू L देन व्हाट विल बी द डी वी कैन टेक इज लेट्स कॉल दिस एंगल इज थीटा इफ दिस एंगल इज थीटा देन इन दिस एंगल OPX OPC the d will be l cos theta the value of l is known to us that is l cos theta plus c so we can get the l we can get the d cos theta plus c into cos theta so we will get cos cos square theta plus c cos theta this is the formula for d d equals to cos cos square theta plus c cos theta similarly we can find out the distance v also from the same triangle in the triangle OPC we can calculate the v will be l sin theta so it will be cos cos theta into sin theta plus c sin theta what I am doing I am multiplying this term cos theta sin theta by 2 multiply by 2 and divide by 2 so this term cos theta sin theta into 2 this will be 2 cos theta sin theta this will become sin 2 theta so I can write it like this half of cos sin 2 theta plus c sin theta this is the formula for v so we are getting v equals to half of cos sin 2 theta plus c sin theta by we will getting the formula for d was cos cos square theta plus c cos theta so these are the two formula we got it this will be useful for us while solving the problems so this is all about the case 2 here one more point we can discuss that I am interested to find out the RL of HPC How we can find out the RL of HPC? If the RL of instrument station is not, then if RL of instrument station is not, then RL of instrument station plus this height h. If I do the addition of these two, I will reach at this level. That is what RL of HPC. So I can get the RL of HPC that RL of instrument station plus the height of instrument. This is one of the way. Or if RL of B is not equal, this RL of B is not equal, then what I can do? The RL of HPC, what it will be? The RL of B is not equal. We want to reach at this level. What we have to do? RL of B plus this CHR minus B. Because if we are at this position, RL of B plus CHR will reach at this position. Now we are interested to reach at this position. So what we have to do? We have to subtract this value of B. So RL of B plus CHR minus B will give us the RL of HPC. So these are like this we can calculate the RL of different points. Now let's go to the case 3. Distance and elevation for angle of depression. Instrument station. This will be the hydro instrument and instrument. Let's call it as H. This is the HPC, positive plane of collimation. This is the point P. This will be the center hair reading. This will be the bottom hair reading. This will be the top hair reading. So, as this is CHR, with respect, as this is central hair reading with respect to this point, so this distance will be CHR. And another term is V. V is what? The distance of central hair point from the horizontal plane of collimation. So, this distance from this point to the central hair point, this will be the V. Let's say this point is C. This is K. This is O. So L equals to OC equals to, and one more thing, that's this angle from HPC to this center hair reading, let's say this is theta. So in this triangle OCK, the L equals to OC, and let's take this formula as K as cos theta plus C. So in the same triangle OCK, D will be, this is the word D, instrument distance of point from instrument to station. This D in the triangle OCK, the triangle OCK, the distance D will be L cos theta. L is known to us. We will multiply this. We will multiply this term with the cos theta. So the first term will be Ks cos theta into cos theta. So it will be cos square theta plus C cos theta. Second is V. In the same triangle, triangle OCK, the V will be L sin theta. The same thing. So the Ks cos theta into sin theta. So we can write like half of Ks sin 2 theta plus C sin theta, because the term Ks cos theta into sin theta. Cos theta into sin theta will be multiplied by 2 divided by 2. So 2 cos theta into sin theta will be the sin 2 theta. And the last term will be multiplied with sin theta, so it will be C sin theta. So this is the formula for D. The formula for D and V are same as for case 2. We were having the case 2. Case 2 was distance and elevation for angle of elevation. In the angle of, in that case also, we were getting D equals to L cos theta, and D was K cos square theta plus C cos theta. Here in this case, that is case 3, for the angle of depression, we are getting the same formula, that is D equals to Ks cos square theta plus C cos theta, as well as the formula for B is also same. There also we are getting the same thing, that is half of Ks sin theta plus C sin theta. Here also we are getting the same, half of Ks sin theta plus C sin theta. So for case 2 as well as for case 3, we are getting the same formula. But for the case 1, for horizontal side, we were having formula that D equals to Ks plus C. So if we take, let's take this only, Ks cos square theta plus C cos theta. Theta will represent the angle of depression. For the horizontal side, we were getting this formula. If for horizontal side theta will be 0, if we keep the theta here 0, the cos theta will be 1. So if we keep the theta equal to 0, we will get this formula only. So the formulas are same, only the way of representation is different. First of all, write what is given. What is given? The first one. Just write first of all. What is given? Cited horizontally, a tachometer reads 1.645 meter and 2.845 meter. Means what is given? The value of THR and PHR is given. So from here we can find out the value of S. What is S? The difference of THR and BHR. This we will calculate. The second thing, what is given? Corresponding to steady hours and vertical guide is staff 120 meter away. Means the distance of the staff station from the instrument point is given. That means the capital D is given. The capital D is 120 meter. Then third one, the focal length of object glass is given. That means the small f is given. How much it is given? 20 centimeter. That means it is 0.2 meter. Fourth point, the distance between the object glass and vertical axis of tachometer is 15 centimeter. That means the small d is given. How much it is? 15 centimeter. That means 0.15 meter. So this is known data to us. We can find out this CHR first. We can find out this S, that is staff intercept. What it will be? It will be 2.840 and difference of 1.645. So the S will be 1.195 meter. This problem belongs to the case 1. Why? Because it is written directly that cited horizontally. The case 1 was what? This distance and elevation for cited horizontally. This is the this problem belongs to case 1. So we will know the formula of the D equals what? Ks plus C. Here K and C are not given directly, but we can calculate it with the help of given other data. What will be K? It will be F divided by I into S. Plus C will be F plus D. What is F? F is given as 0.2 meter. I is we need to find out into S. S is the staff intercept. We have calculated S as 1.195 plus F is 0.2 plus D. D is given as 15 centimeter, that is 0.15 meter, and capital D is also not known, that is 120 meter. We have one equation and only one unknown parameter we have. So if we solve this equation, we will get the value of I, that is 10^-3. We have put every data in the unit of meter, so we will get the answer in terms of what? Meter only. So we can get I. It will be, if we will convert it into centimeter, we have to multiply it with 100. So if we will multiply it with 100, we will get a 0.199 centimeter. This is the problem number 1.
Let's move to another problem.
Problem number 2. What is problem number 2? It is a leveling star is held vertical at a distance of 50 meter and 80 meter from the axis of tachometer. And the star intercept are 0.496 meter and 0.796 meter respectively. Compute the constant of instrument. Constant of instrument are what? The K and C. So we need to find out K and C, what is given. Let's draw the figure first. This is the instrument station. So this is the point number 1. is the point number 2. So polarizing, what is one? A leveling star is held vertical at a distance of 50 meter, 80 meter. Means this is given. This let's call this D as 50 meter. This is given, and D2 as 80 meter. This is given, and as well as this is star intersect. Let's call this S1. This is the star intersect. Let's call this S2. So we are given from the axis of equilibrium and the star intersect are 0.496 and 0.796. So this S1, this is 0.496 meter, while this S2 is 0.796 meter. This is what the given data means. The given is D1 equals to 50 meter, D2 equals to 80 meter, and S1 equals to 0.496 meter, and S2 equals to 0.796 meter. This problem is also belongs to case 1. We know the formula that D equals to KS plus C. From here we can make the two equations, D1 equals to KS1 plus C and D2 equals to KS2 plus C. So D1 equals to KS1 plus C. So this will be 50 equals to S1 is what? 0.496. 0.496 K plus C. Let's call this as equation number 1. Similarly, we can form the equation number 2, that is D2 equals to KS2 plus C. So it will be D2 is 80, S2 is 0.796, K plus C. Let's call this equation number 2. Now, we have two unknown, that is K and C. And we have two equations, two are unknown and we have two equations. So easily we can calculate these two. What we can do, we can substitute equation number 2 minus equation number 1. If I substitute this equation number 1 from equation number 2, the C and C will get cancelled and only these two terms will remain and we can get the K. So what will left out? If we will substitute the equation number 1 from equation number 2, the K will be common, 0.796 minus 0.496 equals to 80 minus 50. From here we can get the value of K. If we solve this, we will get the K equals to 100. Now one constant, we got the one constant, that is multiplying constant. If I keep the value of K, if I substitute the value of K in any one of this equation, we can get the value of C. So let's substitute the value K equals to 100 in equation number 1. So what will I get from here? 50 equals to 0.496 into 100 plus C. If I solve this, I will get the value of C. The value of C will be here 0.4. So like this we can get, like this we can find out the constants of instrument, that is K and C, and we got the K also as 100. So these are the answers. Now let's move to another problem. This is another problem. A tachometer was set up at a point A and the following readings are recorded on a vertical held staff. The instrument is kept at station A and we have the star station, that is benchmark, and the point B, and we have the corresponding angles, and hair readings and remark is given that the the RLF benchmark is 437.655 meter, and we need to find out the horizontal distance of A to B and RLF B if the constant are given that 100 and 0.1. This is the value of K and this is the value of C. This is the multiplying constant, that is the additive constant. Let's draw the figure first. This will be the angle, let's call this as theta 1 equals to 2 degree 18 minutes, right? The corresponding this will be THR1, this will be CHR1, this will be the VHR1. The THR1 means the top hair reading, CHR1 center hair reading, VHR1 means bottom hair reading. So this value, this distance will be CHR1 and this will be V1. Now another stop point, stop station is point B, that is given 8 degree 36 minutes. Means what? This is the angle of elevation. So let's take another one at somewhere here. This is called as point B. This will call, let's call this THR2, and this as BHR2. So this distance will be CHR2, while from this is the HPC line. So this distance will be the V2. And this angle will be theta 2. That is 8 degree 36 minutes. This is what given. So now we need to find out distance of A to B, means from this point to this point. This distance we need to find out from this point. And second is RL of B. So let's calculate first the D, distance of A to B. The distance A to B, it will fall in case 2, that is angle of elevation. So distance formula will be KF cos square theta plus c cos theta. The k is given us as a equals to 100 and c is given 0.4. The DAB, this will be the angle of elevation. For this, the angle is theta 2, that is 8 degree 36 minutes. So let's call this as theta 2. Theta 2. So the value of k is 100 into s. S will be what? THR, difference of THR2 and PHR2. THR2 is This will be 1.65 and 3.38. Difference of this 1.65 and 3.38 will give us the value of S, that is stop intercept. S is what? Difference of THR and VHR. So 3.38 minus 1.65. This will be the S value. So we can keep it directly here, 3.38 minus 1.65 dot cos square, theta is how much? 8 degree 36 minutes. Plus c is given as 0.4 cos 8 degree 36 minutes. If we solve this one, we get distance of A to B as 169.2
5 to 7 meters.
Now we are interested. The second problem is we are interested to find out the RL of point B. The RL of point B. What is given to us? The RL of BM is given. The RL of this point is given. The RL of this point is given. This is the as how much it is? 437.675 meter. This is given. We need to reach at this point. And what we have to do? The RL of point B will be RL of BM, RL of BM plus BHR plus B. If we will do this, we will reach at the position of this HPC plus V1. Then we will reach at the position of HPC. If we do this, then we will reach at the position of RL of HPC. Let's find out first RL of HPC only. Then we will go for that. If we do this, then we will reach at the place of RL of HPC. Once we will reach at the place of RL of HPC, then RL of B will be RL of HPC plus V2 minus THR2 will give us the RL of point B. So let's find out the RL of HPC. The RL of BM is given 437.655. Why is CHR1? CHR1 will be this value. So CHR1, how much it is? It is given 3.55 plus V1. V1 is half of KS sin 2 theta plus C sin theta. K is known, 100. S will be the difference of 3.875 minus 3.225. Why? The theta will be 2 degree 18 minutes. So everything is known. This is what RL of BM, this is THR1, 3.55. While B is half of KS sin 2 theta plus C sin theta. K is given as 100, S will be this difference. And theta is 2 degree 18 minutes. We will put everything. We will get the RL of HPC.
Half of KS sin 2 theta plus C sin theta.
The k is not closed, that is what? 100. S is the intercept of top wear reading and bottom wear reading. For this pairs, the top wear reading and bottom wear reading are this. So, the difference of these two will give us this sub intercept. What it will be? 3.38 minus 1.65. This will be the sub intercept. Why the theta? Theta is 8 degree 36 minute. So everything is known to us. If we solve this, we will get the RL of B. We will compute this formula. If we compute this polynomial, we will get the RL of B as 466.95 meter. This was the final finding. We were asked to find out the RL of the distance of A to B that we have already calculated. The second, the finding was the RL of B. This is the final finding. That is the this final R. This is the final answer. That is RL of B. The RL of this point is 466.95. We were given the RL of this point. This was 437. We were asked to find out the RL of this point. This we got as 466.95. This is all about this problem. Thank you.